Hello everyone. In this video, I'll discuss the digital design of the static RAM block, its basic properties, and store, read, and write operations. A RAM circuit is a type of random access memory that stores data or bits as long as the power is supplied. These memories are volatile, meaning the stored data is erased once the power is turned off. A RAM circuit can be of two types: static RAM and dynamic RAM. In static RAM, the data is stored in a static latch. In these memories, the data remains intact and does not get lost as long as the power is maintained. In contrast, in dynamic RAM, the data is stored in capacitors. The stored data in DRAM gradually fades over time, which needs to be refreshed at regular intervals. SRAMs have faster access time than DRAMs, since these do not require periodic refreshing. However, SRAM cells are larger compared to DRAM, making it more expensive and less dense. Since SRAM does not need constant refreshing, it consumes less power when idle, but more power per bit compared to DRAM during active operation. SRAM cells are used in cache memory in CPUs, high-speed registers, while DRAMs are used in main system memory in most computers. In this video, I'll talk about the static RAM block. Let's start with the digital circuit. The most common circuit for SRAM is 6-transistor or 6T circuit. It consists of two cross-coupled inverters that form a latch, which is the fundamental concept in SRAM design. The inverters connected back-to-back allow the cell to hold a stable 0 or 1 state. Also, there are two-axis transistors controlled by word line to read and write data from bit lines. Here is the complete digital circuit for the 6T SRAM cell. It consists of 6 transistors labeled from M1 to M6. The transistors M5 and M6 act as access transistors that control access to the cell based on the value of the word line WL at their gates. The bit lines BL and BL bar are shown in green and serve as data input and output paths during the read and write operations. The stored data is held at the internal nodes Q and Q bar within the static latch formed by the cross-coupled inverters. These nodes maintain the value as long as the power is supplied. Now let's discuss the mechanism to store, read, and write data in an SRAM cell. First, the store operation. During the store operation, we keep the word line WL at 0. This turns off the access transistors. This disconnection is crucial as it ensures the integrity and the correctness of the stored data in the SRAM cell. Meanwhile, the positive feedback mechanism in the back-to-back inverters maintain the stored value at the storage nodes Q and Q bar. This feedback loop is what makes SRAM cells stable and capable of holding data reliably. To understand the read operation in SRAM cell, let's assume the stored values are Q equals to 1 and Q bar equals to 0. To begin reading, both bit lines BL and BL bar are pre-charged to VDD or logic 1. Then the word line WL is activated by setting it to 1. When the word lines are activated, the access transistors turn on, connecting the bit lines to the storage nodes. On the left side, where bit line is 1 and Q is also 1, there is no change and the data stability is maintained. However, on the other side or the right side, a charge sharing process occurs between bit line bar and Q bar. It's crucial that the value at Q bar drives the bit line and not the other way around. To ensure this, the transistor M1 must be stronger and larger than transistor M5, keeping Q bar to logic 0. Finally, the pre-charged BL bar is discharged to logic 0, completing the read operation. After the read operation, BL is 1 and BL bar is 0. Similar to M1, M3 needs to be larger than M6 to maintain data integrity and avoid unintended state changes. During the read operation in the SRAM cell, something interesting happens. When accessing the node storing 0, for example, node Q bar here, the voltage at Q bar can momentarily rise above 0 due to charge sharing. If this rise in the voltage voltage is more than the switching threshold of the inverter, it can cause the store data to be flipped, leading to a read upset. Read upsets can lead to data corruption and system instability, especially in the applications where data integrity is critical. In order to mitigate this, more robust SRAM cells, for example 12T, 14T cells, are designed to improve read stability and reduce the likelihood of read upsets. After store and read operations, let's walk through the write operation of an SRAM cell step by step. Assume the SRAM cell initially holds a 1 at node Q and 0 at node Q bar. Our goal is to change this stored value and write 0 at Q and 1 at Q bar. In order to do this, we set the word line WL to 1, which turns on the excess transistors and connects the bit lines BL and BL bar to storage nodes Q and Q bar. Then we apply the values which we want to write. For this, we drive the bit line BL to 0 and complementary bit line BL bar to 1. This sets up the new desired data at bit lines. Once the new values are set at BL and BL bar, a key aspect of SRAM write operation is overcoming the previously stored values. In the read operation, we discuss that M1 needs to be stronger than M5 to keep node Q bar at 0 and ensure data integrity and prevent unintended state changes. However, during the write operation, we need to turn off M1 to successfully write the new value. Turning off M1 ensures that the previous data is overwritten, allowing the new values to be stored correctly. To disable M1, the voltage at its gate needs to drop below the threshold voltage or VTH. The gate of M1 is controlled by a resistive divider formed by transistors M4 and M6. By making M6 stronger than M4, the zero on bit line is effectively driven to Q, helping to change the stored value. As soon as the voltage at node Q drops below the threshold voltage VTH, M1 turns off, allowing Q bar getting set to 1 and Q to 0. This completes writing Q equals to 0 and Q bar equals to 1 in the SRAM cell. 6T SRAM cell design is robust. It is one of the most popular choices for memory block design. However, there are certain limitations when it comes to scaling up these SRAM blocks to large arrays. Let's discuss these. As the SRAM block size grows, the word and the bit lines become longer. This increase leads to higher resistance and capacitance, causing slower read and write access times. Signals take longer to travel across large memory arrays, further reducing overall speed and performance. From power consumption perspective, larger SRAMs consume more static power due to leakage current, since each cell contains multiple transistors. Dynamic power also increases as larger bit and word lines require more energy to charge and discharge. To address these limitations, designers use various strategies. Large SRAM blocks are divided into smaller subarrays to reduce access time and minimize power consumption. Designers implement hierarchical word line and bit line structure that effectively reduce capacitance and improve access speed. In order to reduce power, power gating techniques are used. Inactive sections of the SRAM are power gated to minimize leakage power and thus reduce unnecessary energy loss. So this is all for this video. I hope this helped you to gain a clear understanding of SRAM cells